What wonderful sunshine here in Rio de Janeiro. It's approaching 11:30 in the morning. Our next A final, our next gold medal race comes in the men's double sculls. This is an event just like Bond and Murray dominate the pair. The Sinković brothers from Croatia tend to blow the rest out of the water in the double sculls. So from sweep, it's back to sculling, and we have GB, Norway, Croatia, Lithuania, Italy, and France in this A final. Crossing lane one, the two Johns, Walton and Collins. Maybe underachievers is a fair description of their form, but they're in this Olympic final. Borch and Tufte, huge experience. Tufte is a silver, a medalist back in Sydney in this event before he took care of the gold medal at previous Olympics in the single. Sinković and Sinković, the brothers, are the overwhelming favourites here. They've only ever lost one race as a double. Griskonis, the replacement in the Lithuanian doubles boat, is partnered with Ritter. They go in four. Fossi and Battisti, can they channel the spirit of Abagnale and Di Costanzo from the pair? They go in five. Battisti won a silver in London with Alessio Sartori. Boucheron and Mandrodias of France are in lane six. The calm before the storm of racing. Croatia in lane three, the overwhelming favourites here in the final of the men's double sculls. The Sinković brothers, who broke through at the 2014 World Championships in Amsterdam when they came through the six-minute barrier, the first time this had ever been achieved in this boat class, the double sculls. So they're going in lane three, Tufte and Borch to their right. Remember, Olaf Tufte was an Olympic champion in the single sculls in Athens and Beijing. He was ninth in the London final. He's also raced in the four and the double sculls before. So what a rower with experience, and so versatile, Olaf Tufte, with Kjetil Borch, his partner here in the bow seat in Rio 2016. Won the B final with Nils Jakob Hoff in London. So tremendous experience there. No surprise here to see the Croatians striding out to build a lead in this first 500. It's Griskonis and Ritter in lane four, going well, second at this point to the Croatians.
We saw the Croatians lose a skull in their heat in rough conditions. The wind continuing to pick up here at Lagoa, and at the moment they're handling it reasonably well. You see the boats everywhere sort of getting knocked about. Good start from Lithuania. Our silver medalists coming into this. Grigonis obviously coming in late as a replacement after the injury to the bowman, coming off his bike and breaking his hand, unfortunately, and they're doing a good job to hang on to the Croatians. Tight for third, though.
Croatia, Lithuania, and then France currently in the bronze medal position, but it's very, very tight after the Lithuanians in second place. And it would be a fantastic performance from them. Griskonis and Ritter, they lost their A-team, if you will. Solius Ritter was always going to be in this boat. He was sixth in the 2012 final with Rolandas Mašinskas, and that was the lineup they hoped to bring to Rio, but Mašinskas got injured. So Griskonis came across from the single skull competition, and Kelmalis filled in there. He finished way down the order in the singles, but Griskonis, vastly experienced, three-timer, a Euro champion in the singles, world bronze medalist last year, six medals overall at the Worlds, and bringing all his experience into this double skulls boat. But it is the Sinković brothers, seasoned quad racers, weren't they, in that famous Croatian quad. An injury disrupted that, particular teaming, and they've moved into the double sculls boat and stroking 37 there, but being pushed by the Lithuanians.
Yeah, they're definitely moving back on them. The Croatians almost arguably been said to be as dominant as the New Zealand men's pair through this cycle. But they've found a new challenger here, definitely from Lithuania.
GB nowhere in lane one at present, and so tight at midway here. Just 23 hundredths the gap between Croatia and Lithuania, and then 5 seconds back come the Norwegians, Italy, France, and GB propping up the rear. Collins and Walton struggling over there in lane one. This wasn't a realistic medal hope, really, when you look at the men's double sculls as far as Team GB were concerned. It's been a disappointing regatta so far for GB, and Collins and Walton are not going to change that. It's neck and neck, really, between Sinkovic, and Griškonis and Ritter. Croatia against Lithuania here, with Norway trying to get back at them in lane two. It's the Norwegians third at this point.
Well, I think Grigonis has been quoted as saying that he likes rowing the single. He likes being by himself, and I'm sure he would have been pretty uncertain about moving into this combination because he thought he had a shot at a medal in a single. But all that probably put to one side now as he's enjoying the feeling of leading out the Sinkovic brothers through the third 500. Fantastic performance from them. Both very powerful men. Bit of difference in size there. But Grigonis doing a great job. The guys actually moving away from Croatia.
This would be a real shock, actually. The biggest shock we've seen so far if Griškonis and Ritter can hold on to this advantage. And they're threatening to push out on the Sinkovic brothers. They've spent this season winning by open water margins, the Croatian double sculls crew here. It's a wide open boat class. Top step of the podium, changing flags from one Olympics to the next in recent decades. At the past nine games, from Moscow 80 to London 2012, eight nations have won the gold medal. And we could be about to see another here if Lithuania can claim a stunning win from the Croatians. But this is where Sinkovic need to push, and they are doing so.
That's right. Yep, they've moved back up on Lithuania from that shot there. Looks like they've just got their bow back in front. Amazing response. Battle two going on for the bronze medal. Norway and Italy still in touch together, coming through the semi-final. Croatia, Lithuania both won those within a second of each other's times. And at the moment, Croatia seen off that big move from Lithuania, and now that lift in rating has seen them move past almost half a length. Great response from the world champions.
They are a class act, the Sinkovic brothers. And they have had the answer to the questions posed by the Lithuanians, and Tufte and Kjetil Borsch in lane two are going brilliantly. Tufte is already in that exclusive Olympic club. He's the only man racing in Rio with three Olympic medals, and he's going to get another by the looks of things with Kjetil Borsch in lane two. It's Norway coming up for the bronze medal. Brilliant from Sinkovic.
Yeah, the Sinkovic brothers, Martin and Valen. Such pedigree there, I guess. Maybe the rough conditions meant they let the Lithuanians get away, but what a response. Moving back from half length down to half a length up in the space of 300 metres. And they get to come to the line now. All that expectation delivered. Olympic champions, Lithuania in second. And Norway with Olaf Tufte in third. His fifth Olympic Games and his third Olympic medal.
Brilliant there from Tufte and Bjorch in third place, but the favourites have won, Martin and Valent Sinkovic. Goodness me, though, they were pushed by the Lithuanians. They might not have expected that. They've been world champs the last 2 years, and now they have Olympic medals hanging around their necks. That's gold medals. Silver in the quad. But Griškonis and Ritter, with this half-scratch crew for Lithuania, have won a phenomenal silver.
Yeah, a good result for them. I think it's they'll be asking themselves questions about whether they could have held that wine better. Great result for Norway. Big change to bring Olaf Tufte into that boat. Nils Hoff went into the single, qualified through, and here they are, bronze medalists in Rio.
That's how close it was between lanes 3 and 4, Croatia and Lithuania, for so long. Indeed, the Lithuanians had pushed their bow ball ahead at one stage, just coming over the 1,000 meters, but that is why these two are the dominant pairing in this boat class, Martin Sinkevich and Valent Sinkevich. Half of that outstanding quad with Damir Martin and David Nain, winning 2 world champs in the Olympic silver. But however good that quad was, it's nothing compared to this double. Absolutely brilliant.
Yeah, I think the move to the double was always about this moment, crowning them, getting the crown of Olympic champions. And they've delivered all their past performances. As you said, Andy, definitely asked a question there by the Lithuanians, who look, they were moving down for a recovery row there, not sort of mucking around at the finish line at all, still rowing, moving into the pontoon. Lithuania get their second medal of the day after the women's double.
Oh, what a venue and what a shot. That's looking north up to the statue of Christ the Redeemer on Corcovado Mountain, who will approve of the surge to the line won by the Sinkevich brothers of Croatia. Single sculls gold medalist in 08 and 04. He got his silver in the double back in 2000. What an Olympic career.
Yep. There's 6 Olympic Games. And his 4th Olympic medal. The silver in Sydney in the double. So I guess he gets the full set then. Bronze, silver and gold. And after finishing 9th in London, great return to the podium.
Kjetil Borsch won the B final in 2012 in London. With Hoff. The bronze for Norway.
Silver medalists representing Lithuania. Medalla di prata representando a Lituania. Mindaugas Griskonis, Saulius Rita.
That's Mindaugas Griskonis, 30 years of age, building his whole year and this whole Olympiad to racing in the singles. But here he is with a medal in the double scull boat with his buddy, Saulius Ritter.
Yeah, well, you can see Griskonis, he's pretty happy with that, I think. They certainly had a great race, and more than anything, I think you want to walk away from an Olympics knowing that you put your best race out there. And they certainly gave Croatia a hurry up, leading them into that last 500 before Croatia responded.
Medaille d'or indeed. Gold medal for the Sinkevich brothers from Croatia. Valent, who stroked the Croatians to victory there. Martin in the bow seat. What a combination.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Did have 1 or 2 scares throughout 2016. Valent had a bit of a back niggle. So they dropped out of racing at Poznan in that last World Cup of the season. Good decision. Here they are with a gold. So no seismic upset in the men's double sculls here. The favourites won the gold medal.